Welcome to my new animated series, where I hope to cover topics about reptiles, but also broader topics regarding science and nature. My name is Rebecca, this is Leopard Gecko, and today we're looking at internal parasites. What they are, how they affect your reptiles, and how to treat them. Quick disclaimer, I am not an exotics vet, this should not be taken as medical advice, and if you are concerned about your reptile, please see a vet. Reptiles can catch a range of parasites, however if kept alone, in a clean environment, fed captive bred insects, away from potentially infected feces, then the likelihood of your reptile getting any of these is quite low, but it is important to know what your reptile can catch and what signs to look out for. I have decided to cover the 5 most common internal parasites your reptile can catch. First, let's look at pinworms. Pinworms are actually incredibly common, partly because they don't often present any outwardly negative symptoms. Therefore, they're very easy to pass from one animal to another. Reptiles will usually catch pinworms from infected feeder insects. This is why it's important to feed captive bred insects. But if you do choose to feed wild caught ones, then be prepared to test your gecko's feces often to ensure it is not infected. Symptoms include reduced appetite, weight loss, and diarrhea. Treatment for pinworm includes a deworming medication. It is also important to keep your reptile in a sterile environment for the duration of the treatment, so that you can ensure the environment is clean and the animal cannot reinfect itself. Next, we have roundworms. Now, thankfully, these worms are easy to detect as they'll appear in your reptile's feces. Just imagine tiny strands of spaghetti. Yeah, that's what you'll see. Now, roundworms can be contracted if your reptile eats infected feces. Once again, an exotics vet should determine that your reptile is indeed infected with roundworm and prescribe an effective dewormer. Another worm your reptile can get is hookworm. The most obvious sign that your reptile has hookworm is their stools will be bloody. This is because, like the name suggests, they hook onto the inside of your pet, specifically the lining of the intestines. Next we have Coccidia. This is a single-celled parasite that affects the lining of the intestinal tract, or the bile duct. Symptoms include diarrhea, a reduced appetite, lethargy, blood or mucus in the reptile's feces, and dehydration. This parasite is particularly difficult to pick up on a fecal examination, but the symptoms should give your vet a good idea that your reptile is infected. And finally, Cryptosporidium, or if you're a leopard gecko owner, you may know this better as sticktail. Now, I have covered this particular parasite in a video of its own, which I will link below, but this rather nasty parasite is not only extremely infectious, but sadly it's incurable. This particular parasite will spread rapidly in unhygienic, overcrowded environments. Proper hygiene should always be top priority when handling or caring for an animal, whether that's handling one animal or going from tank to tank. If you're unaware that one of your animals has this parasite, and then you go from tank to tank without washing your hands, you could easily spread it and wipe out an entire collection. Not only that, but humans can get this too. You should seek medical advice if you start to become unwell. The most obvious sign that your animal has this, particularly if you have a leopard gecko, is an extremely thin tail. But as I said, I will leave a link to the video I did on this subject below. So to sum up this video, if you are ever concerned about your reptile's health, please see an exotics vet. To lessen the risks of your animal becoming infected, buy your pet from a reputable breeder who has a high standard of hygiene and does not overcrowd their tanks. Feed captive bred insects from a trusted distributor, and quarantine any new animal you buy for at least 9 to 12 weeks. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.